As a story, First Night doesn't have anything new to offer, but as a genre, it's interesting to see where it's been in comparison to where it's going.
Canada be damned. I'm going to the Klondike.
The Klondike is Canada.
Giorgio, you be doing just fine, brother.
A tale as old as time, as the saying goes. In an era of what seems like a bottomless pit of sequels and reboots, perhaps it's worth revisiting a reboot on a story which predates all the modern legacies. Jerry Zucker's 1995 medieval romantic adventure drama First Night is an adaptation of the King Arthur story, a tale that's old by anyone's metric. And yet, despite being centuries old, there's very little about this folklore which the average person knows beyond a few key points.
The Round Table.
Yeah.
Those holes in the public's knowledge make the King Arthur story prime for a film adaptation, because it allows the filmmakers the flexibility to put their own spin on it. In case you're unfamiliar with the King Arthur story, but more specifically First Night, the film begins by introducing us to Lancelot, a handsome vagabond played by Richard Gere, who makes his living town-to-town sword-fighting locals.
Good. Now, you want to know how to win a sword fight?
Hell.
Be the only one with a sword. Easy.
Lancelot thwarts a kidnapping attempt on Guinevere, the Lady of Lyonesse, played by Julia Ormond, and in doing so ignites a fiery crush within himself.
Doesn't it please you to know you saved the life of a lady?
Be just as pleased if you were a dairymaid.
A dairymaid couldn't reward you as I can.
If she was as pretty as you, she could give me all the reward I wanted.
However, Guinevere is spoken for being engaged to King Arthur, played by the late Sean Connery, as the ruler of fiction's most notorious metropolis.
I was still a boy when I first climbed this hill and saw what was to become my city. I named it Camelot.
Yet this royal engagement doesn't dissuade Lancelot from pursuing Guinevere in a pushy and racy game of cat and mouse. And while all of this is happening, First Night's villain, played by Ben Cross, is plotting behind the scenes for the downfall of all that's good and all whom stand in his way. First Night takes a realistic approach to the King Arthur tale, and forgoes the fantasy elements like witches, dragons, and magic. It's a far cry from Game of Thrones, yet it's no lesser for taking that approach. Although First Night has plenty of violence, it's what I'd call clean medieval. That's not strictly in reference to the severity of First Night's PG-13 violence, but also, quite literally, the cleanliness of the world. Unlike the modern medieval TV series that have a worn-in texture which feels uniform throughout the world between its makeup and costumes, the cleanliness of First Night feels far more contrasting, yet no less purposeful. Maleagant and his men are rustic bandits who live in castle ruins, which shouldn't come as a surprise given their filthiness. They're distinguishable by their particular costume design, although there's no single matching design for everyone. Whereas King Arthur, his men, and the people of Camelot are at the opposite end of that spectrum. Everyone looks clean and fresh, faces look washed, hair looks groomed, clothing and uniforms look crisp and pristine, and even the townsfolk, not just the soldiers, wear blue to go with the official color of the city. Hardly a soul in Camelot looks disheveled or downtrodden, which is the essence of clean medieval, less Jack Sparrow and more Halloween pirate. It's almost as if hygiene is mandated by Camelot. No! However, not everything in First Night is so cut and dry clean. As much as it's a romance story, it's uncertain to me whether First Night would look the same romantically if it were produced in the 21st century. If it weren't for the changing culture and the fact that the world swooned over Richard Gere post Pretty Woman, it's hard to imagine a romance story unfolding today the way it did in First Night. I.e., if a woman says no, keep pestering her until you wear her down, she submits, and then plant one on her in a way that's less romantic and more hardcore. Ugh, Jesus, get a room. To the Arthurian purist, First Night deprives them of their dose of fantasy, and for those watching it for the first time in the post-Hobbit era, they may be tearing their hair out asking,
why?
Why?
But as much as I enjoy fantasy, I enjoy this realistic take just as much.
Oh, I know what I want. But I can't have everything I want, can I?
One of the few realistic things in First Night that makes me tear my hair out is the fact that Arthur never gets the hint of investing in crossbows because it seems like his men are exclusively dying from crossbows. Jesus, is anybody in Camelot going to put two and two together? Although it's never addressed, I suspect this is more clean medieval in that good guys fight honorably and the bad guys fight dirty. Again, this isn't Game of Thrones where everyone's morality is murky. And that clear definition between good and bad is what makes First Night's traditional approach compelling, especially when it comes to Connery and Cross.
Your fine words are talking you out of peace and into war.
There's a peace that's only to be found on the other side of war. If that battle must come, I will fight it.
And I!
And I!
And I!
And I!
The great Arthur and his great dream.
It's been almost 30 years since First Night arrived on the scene, and like any film of a certain age, First Night does show the chinks in its armor from time to time. It's not flawless, and in some ways may have not aged perfectly. Nevertheless, First Night brings a level of vigor and performance on par with its modern medieval counterparts. And if a stripped-down tale as old as time can still find energy in the present day, perhaps that's something to take note of and shoot for first and foremost.